When I first discovered Zaxby's Big Zax Snack Meal, I couldn't believe all the delicious food you get for such a great price.
Dad, Clay Matthews!
What up, Playa?
It used to be my little secret.
Hey, Clay.
Hey, guys.
Thanks, Clay.
But you know, once something catches on.
The Big Zax Snack Meal. Three of our delicious chicken fingers, seasoned crinkle fries, Texas toast, and Zax sauce. Served with a 22-ounce drink, all for just $5.49. Zaxby's, indescribably good.
You know, first of all, you got to really congratulate, you know, Texas A&M's team. They played a tremendous game and certainly outplayed us in a game today. You know, their offense is a very difficult offense to stop. We didn't start out very well defensively, giving up 20 points the first three times they had the ball. And we probably, you know, dug a ditch that we couldn't quite dig out of. But you got to give them a lot of credit. We didn't play our best game today. We didn't execute the way that we need to execute. And, you know, that starts with me. I take full responsibility for not having our team more ready to do the things that they needed to do to have a chance to be successful in this game. We really had a lot of, you know, undisciplined, missed assignments, not playing with the kind of discipline you have to play with, especially against their quarterback, whether it's pass rush lanes or execution of pressures or whatever it might be. And 0-for-7 in the beginning of the game on third down kept every one of their drives alive, which led to points. We played better as the game went on, but we still didn't make the plays that we needed to make. You know, we had an opportunity at the end of the game, 4th and 2 at the 2, and also had an opportunity to get the ball back with probably what would have been about 35 seconds in the game with pretty good field position. And again, you know, jumped off sides on a hard count, which is, you know, something that you most certainly expect in a situation like that. And the players were, you know, told, make sure you stay on sides. They're going to try to get you to jump off sides with a shift or a motion or something. And players are disappointed, but you know, I think there's a lot of lessons to be learned here relative to what we can do, what we didn't do. Are we making the kind of progress that we need to make? And you know, this team can still accomplish a lot. We have 2 games left. Everybody needs to recommit themselves to playing a little better and being a little more consistent and being somebody that they can trust us, that we're going to put them in a good situation, and we can trust them that they're going to go do that and execute it the way you need to have a chance to be successful as a team. You know, 2 of the 3 national championship teams that I coached, you know, both lost a game. 2 of those teams lost a game. This team still has an opportunity to win the West, go to the SEC championship game and have a chance to win a championship game. So there's still a lot for this team to play for and a lot for them to set their mind to and recommit themselves to. This team has, you know, really done a good job all year long, worked hard. I was really concerned about this week. We seemed like we were a little bit out of gas, you know, this week. And Texas A&M is a really good team, and they played really, really well. And their quarterback's a fantastic player, and he obviously made some plays that, you know, were great plays out there. And you have to have a tremendous amount of discipline to play against a guy like that. And there were times when we didn't quite get it done the way we'd like to. So I think our players will recommit themselves and do the things that they need to do to finish the season the right way, and hopefully have an opportunity to accomplish something of significance, you know, with this particular team.